So one thing I can do is I can make the this program is already simpler, right? So I can make this program more simpler. So what I can do is I can delete this, okay, unnecessary code. Okay, after taking the num as input, what I can do, I can say num by 10 or num mod 10. Okay, num mod 10 will give me 5, the second digit. Okay, as we have seen here, num mod 10 will give me the second digit. So I have to multiply the second digit by 10, and then I have to add num by 10 to this. So that will add the first digit, and this is the answer. So this is a reduced form of the code. So if I am going for like a condensed form of this program, so this program will end in like 9 lines, which is a single digit number. So in 9 lines, you're going to get the answer for this program. So this will also run, say I'm going to enter 67. So I'm going to get 76 as the answer. So just copy this question. So in your examination, okay, so please remember this, don't do this. So you don't exit the programming window. So since this is a mock test, I am doing that. So please don't exit the mock test. So you have to code here itself and submit the program, okay? So please don't exit it. So I'm going to submit the code. I'll recompile this code. In the actual exam, your code will get compiled on click of this button. So this is not an actual exam, so they're not going to compile this, okay? So you can just submit this. And it will say you can use C language, C++, Java, Python, and Perl programming languages to solve this, okay? So we have taken C, okay? So I could also have taken C or Java. I know all this, except for Perl. I don't know this Perl programming language. So this is like an old programming language. So except for this, they have even written the spelling of the Python wrong. Okay, so I don't know all these programming languages, but I took C since because we have practiced C language in our previous videos in this channel. So that is the end of the examination. I ended my examination. Thank you. Your exam is about to be submitted. Click OK to proceed. Are you sure you want to submit the exam? So at the last moment, you want to change your program. So you can click cancel and you can go back and edit your code again. Okay, but you cannot go to your previous parts like MCQs and English questions. Okay, so I'm going to click OK now. My test will be submitted and it will show me feedback form where I can answer a question about seating arrangement. So you have to go to the test center and write it. So they're going to ask you feedback about how was the examination, how was the seating arrangement, how was the staff in the how were the staff in the examination center, were they friendly to you, etc. So you can give the feedback and your examination is complete. So after you get this information in your test center, you can easily walk out of your test center with a happy face, thinking that you have easily solved TCS NQT examination. So that is about this video. So my bad. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions about the questions that were solved in this mock examination, do comment them below. So subscribe to our channels for more videos on any interview preparation, examination, any study stuff. We are here to help you to study. And once again, thank you for watching.